Maker's Corner Comedy Collective 2022. What's your name?
Patrick.
Patrick, the electrician, who I may need for my wires doing or something. I don't know. That was on you. I didn't. That was you. Bringing the spark back to my life, Patrick. He's smooth. He is smooth. Sarah Keyworth!
See me any gaze in? That feels good, doesn't it? That's nice. Oh, I see what you're doing here. Outsourcing your diversity. People come to your events, we go, look, we've got a lesbian. That's very nice. It's very nice. I look gay, don't I? It's a corporate room, you're terrified to say yes. Get HR in here immediately. I do, I look gay, I don't mind that. I recently got told I look so gay, I look like the secretly gay one in a boy band. It's not untrue, is it? It's my girlfriend that said that, not very nice. Yeah.
The wonderful Josh Jones!
I was on a late night train and there was only me and one woman on the carriage and she was sat facing me but quite a few rows back and I could see she was very tense, you know, a woman travelling on her own at night, so she had a guard up. But then my phone rang and she heard my gay voice and straight away her body language changed. She just became really relaxed and really chilled out, so I mugged her. It was... absolute fantastic night.
Sarah Barron!
It, as already implied, this is not Canadian. This is the bad one. And it's how you feel, isn't it? I feel like, look at your face, you're so sad already. And I don't even blame you. I feel what happens is you guys hear this noise and you get like a little anxiety. You're set like this. You're like so nervous that I'm gonna spend our time together like talking about how awesome shit is. USA, fuck yeah. I'm not gonna do that. I have lived here now for 10 years and across that decade, you fuckers have exfoliated the positivity right off me. So you're the real heroes.
Kwame Asante!
But when I'm not performing stand-up comedy, I work as an A&E doctor in NHS. I'm gonna be honest, that is a way more wholesome reaction than what I'm used to getting. Normally when I'm at a bar or a party and people find out I'm an A&E doctor, they're like, what's the weirdest thing you've pulled out of a patient's bum? And unfortunately the answer to that is always the same, my own finger. Which kills every conversation. Because no one's ready for the truth, ladies and gentlemen.
Helen Bauer!
I feel like I arrive on stage and most of the men in the room just look at me like, no. No. This can't be it. She is way too fuckable to be funny. Thank you. Radio 4 just looking awkwardly at me now. Like, I knew it. Why would she have a personality with those tits? And it's fair, okay? Just a crazy lucky babe with an amazing personality and incredible rack. Know what I mean? Fucking yes! Honestly, people would say that's too confident of a start, but some of the filth that's been on the stage tonight, I genuinely feel fine by it.
Ria Lina!
Can you cheer if you're on the dating apps?
Oh my goodness, that's wonderful. Let's just, we'll meet afterwards. We'll do. I saw you earlier actually on Grindr. But so I'm on them all. Why not? You got to see what's out there. I'm willing to experiment. And I'm loving it. It's so much better than meeting in real life. It's so awkward to meet someone in real life, isn't it? Especially if you don't like them, because you have to literally go up to them and go, ugh. Right? You don't have to do that on your phone. It's so clinical. It's so easy. It's just a little swipe. Just a little swipe. All right? I'm on my phone all the time now. I can literally shop for dick while I shit.
Bloody Kadi!
The Eddie in me really wants to go for it. But I'm a gangster. Girls just want to have fun, but boys do not want to have fun. Play it again. This is the gangster in me. Let's go. to live your life.
Oh, it was absolutely amazing. My jaw and my abs are still hurting right now because it was that funny.